डिस्कस करेंगे क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कोलाइडस. द क्लासिफिकेशन इज बेस्ड ऑन इंटरैक्शंस बिटवीन डिस्पर्सल फेज एंड डिस्पर्शन मीडियम. वी नो दैट कोलाइड इज अ हेटेरोजेनस सिस्टम कंटेनिंग डिस्पर्सल फेज एंड डिस्पर्शन मीडियम. So, on the basis of the interactions between these two phases, dispersal phase and dispersion medium, we can classify colloids, or colloids are classified into two types, lyophilic colloids and lyophobic colloids. So, first of all, we'll take lyophilic colloid. What is lyophilic colloid? Lyophilic colloid means solvent-loving colloid, solvent-loving or liquid-loving. So, in lyophilic colloids, the dispersal phase, what this solid loving means? That means the dispersal phase has great affinity, great love for dispersion medium. You know, that means the dispersal phase will easily interact. There is a strong force between dispersal phase and dispersion medium. That means dispersal phase has a great affinity for dispersion medium. So these type of colloids, that means lyophilic colloids, these are directly formed by mixing dispersal phase with dispersion medium. यानी इनको हम easily बना सकते हैं. Dispersal phase और dispersion medium को हम mix करते हैं, फिर shake करते हैं, we'll get the lyophilic colloid. For example, if we'll take starch in water, starch को water में डालेंगे, so उसको हम थोड़ा shake करेंगे, we'll get a colloid, lyophilic colloid. So these are also known as intrinsic colloids. So lyophilic colloids are also called intrinsic colloids. If we'll separate the two, for example, if we'll separate dispersal phase from dispersion medium, we can reconstitute the colloid. हम इसको reconstitute कर सकते हैं simply by adding a dispersion medium to the dispersal phase. In a dispersal phase को हम dispersion medium करेंगे, फिर add and this colloid can be reconstituted. उसको हम reconstitute कर सकते हैं. So because of this reason, these colloids are said to be reversible colloids. ये reversible colloids है. इन एक बार इनको हम अलग करेंगे, फिर हम उनको दोबारा मिक्स करेंगे, तो फिर ये कोलाइड बनेगा. दे विल पास इनटू कोलाइड. सो दीज आर रिवर्सिबल कोलाइड्स. सो लाइफली कोलाइड्स आर रिवर्सिबल कोलाइड्स. ये स्टेबल है, स्टेबल होते हैं एंड कैन नॉट बी इजिली कोगुलेटेड. इनको हम इजिली कोगुलेट नहीं कर सकते, इनको हम इजिली पर्सपिरेट नहीं कर सकते, बिकॉज दे आर स्टेबल. ये स्टेबल होते हैं. अब अगर वाटर होगा एज ए सॉल्वेंट, एज ए डिस्पर्शन मीडियम अगर वाटर होगा, देन दीज आर कॉल्ड हाइड्रोफिलिक. इनको हम बोलते हैं हाइड्रोफिलिक कोलाइड्स बोलते हैं इनको. यानी अगर सॉल्वेंट होगा यहां पर वाटर, डिस्पर्शन मीडियम होगा वाटर, देन दीज आर कॉल्ड हाइड्रोफिलिक कोलाइड्स. उनको हम कभी बोलते हैं हाइड्रोसॉल्स. Hydrosols, क्योंकि यहां पर solvent water है, solvent level water है, so these are also called hydrosols. Now we have one more, that is lyophobic. Lyophobic colloid means solvent hating colloid or liquid hating colloid. That means there is a little affinity होती है इस colloid में. Dispersal phase की little affinity होती है towards dispersion medium. That means the force of attraction, any force of attraction between the two phases is not very much larger. That is small. बिल्कुल little affinity होती है, little love होता है dispersal phase का towards the dispersion medium. So in short, we can say that in lyophobic colloids, the dispersal phase has a little affinity for the dispersion medium. So these are not formed by simply mixing the dispersal phase with the dispersion medium. इनको हम simply mixing से नहीं बना सकते. सो टू फॉर्म दीज कोलाइड्स, इनको बनाने के लिए वी नीड स्पेशल मेथड्स, यानी स्पेशल मेथड चाहिए इनको बनाने के लिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मेटल्स, मेटल्स या उनकी जो मेटल सल्फाइड जो होते हैं, सल्फाइड्स, ये हमें देते हैं यानी लाइफोबिक कोलाइड. अगर इनको हम पानी में डालेंगे सो विल गेट लाइफोबिक कोलाइड्स. सो वी कैन नॉट प्रिपेयर दिस कोलाइड्स बाय सिंपली बाय शेकिंग. वी नीड स्पेशल मेथड्स for the preparation of these lyophobic colloids. So these are also called extrinsic colloids. So these colloids, these lyophobic colloids are readily precipitated. इनको हम easily precipitate कर सकते हैं on addition of electrolyte by adding a small quantity of electrolyte like NaCl, KCl, or by heating करेंगे, or by shaking करेंगे. So they can be readily coagulated by either by adding electrolyte, addition of electrolyte, small quantity of electrolyte, or by heating or by shaking. These are not stable. These stable nahi hote. They are made stable by adding a small quantity of electrolyte. Ek baar inki precipitation ho gayi, once coagulated are precipitated, They do not give back the colloid. इन्हें दोबारा हम उसको colloid नहीं बना सकते. एक बार coagulate हो गए, once coagulated or once precipitated, they do not give back the colloid. They cannot be brought back into the colloid. उनको हम colloid नहीं बना सकते. So these are because of this reason, they are said to be irreversible colloids. Irreversible colloids होते हैं. These are irreversible colloids. So this is the main difference. Lyophilic are reversible, lyophobic are irreversible colloids. They need, अभी हमने बोला आपको, these colloids are not stable. They need stabilizing agents like electrolytes for their preservation. यानी उनको preserve करने के लिए हमें चाहिए stabilizing agents like electrolytes. So if the solvent is water, agar in mein solvent water ho gaya, dispersion medium water ho gaya, so then these are called hydrophobic. Unko hum bolte hain hydrophobic colloids bolte hain. So agar yahan par water ho gaya as dispersion medium, so this was the classification of the colloids based on interactions between dispersal phase and dispersion medium. So on this basis, we have classified colloids. We have two types of colloids, lyophilic and lyophobic. So if water is a solvent, then lyophilic are called hydrophilic colloids, and lyophobic colloids are called hydrophobic colloids. That means water-loving and water-hating in case of lyophobic, water-hating. In case of lyophilic, water-loving. Okay, thanks.